Do you want to learn how to make money and more of it? This might sound crazy, but the things that I'm going to teach you in this video are considered a highly regarded secret and only a few people know about it. I'm going to pull back the curtain of what is money, where is it going, and how do you make a little bit more of it, coming up next. Hey guys, it's Bill here with BillStenzel.com, and today I'm gonna break down money for you. And I'm breaking it down into three categories so you can easily understand it. Everyone that I know wants to make money, but very few people even know what money is. I will do my best to keep it as simple as possible, but the things that I'm about to tell you are actually really hard to believe. I do believe you could learn about it, and what my job today is to get you guys on the right side of the equation so you can know exactly what it is, exactly what you're looking for, so it gives you the opportunity to make a little bit more of it. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please at least consider it. I put out videos every single week. I practice what I preach. I own business. I teach business, I live business, and I put these videos out just for you. So if you like what you see here, please let me know in the comments section below. But you came here to learn about money, and we're starting right now. Category number one, what are those? If you say that this is money, I think you and I need to hang out for a little bit. And if you said, yes, I know what that is, that, my friend, is called currency, then you know what, you could just shut off your laptop, you don't ever have to watch another YouTube again. You are a financial genius. And actually, you're so amazing that people beg you to do their taxes because they know you're gonna save them a ton of cash. And if you're like, dude, that's money, and you're an idiot, which I completely agree with you. That's why I call this channel Terrible Financial Advice. I did embark on a journey to visit Mr. Google, and I typed this in: properties of money. Here is the characteristics of money. It needs to be durable, or durability. It needs to be portable. It needs to be acceptable. There needs to be limited supply of it. It has to be divisible, uniformity, and last, money acts as a unit of account and a medium of exchange, now here's the biggest one, and a store of value. Now, here is where the problem lies. Your currency that you guys trade that looks like this, that on the top of it says Federal Reserve Note, does not hold value over a long period of time. But it's okay because no currency ever has held value over time. But I need to back up my claim. I need to back up my claim with a story. And the story I like to always use is about Disneyland, my most favorite place on earth. Well, actually I have a really hot wife, so it's not my most favorite place on earth, which I don't know where I'm going with that, and I probably should edit this out on the video. Okay, sorry about that. When you go into Disneyland, back in the day, if you were the first one to go into the park, you would have walked in and you would have used this thing right here called currency, and you would have handed it to them, and then they would have said, come on in. It was $1. I know this is hard to believe, but Disneyland was $1 to get in. Now, I like to use Disneyland as an example because I want to show you how currency never holds its value over time. And I know people like to say, Bill, that's called inflation. It's not. It's just showing you the death of these things and how you need more of them. Have you ever heard of a motel called Motel 6? And a bigger question for you is, do you know why they call it Motel 6? The very first Motel 6 opened in 1962 in Southern California, Santa Barbara, about an hour west of here where I live. And the reason why they call it Motel 6 is because of their room rates. You could get a room at Motel 6 for $6. So I went to their website to book a room for my wife and I, and guess what I found? It looks like your money no longer stores its value because I now need 28 of them rather than one. The grand total was $167.99. So basically, just to reinforce how your currency doesn't store value whatsoever, go try to book a room. It's not $6 anymore for Motel 6, it's $168. Let's just say it's almost as bad as Disneyland. So category one of the three forms of money that I'm gonna be talking about really isn't even money after all. So that green stuff that you guys have in your pocket that's called a Federal Reserve note, that's all it is. It's just a note and it's just currency. Now that you know a little bit more about currency, can you think of something in the world that would store its value, but still have the six properties that we discussed earlier in the video? Which leads us into category number two of money. Well, if you said gold or silver, you're a really wise human, my friend. So here is a minted gold coin, and let me see if I can drop everything and put a silver coin. I would probably rather have a lot more of these, see if it'll zoom in, than these, because the value is completely different. The value currently of shooting this video, the value of this is around $1,300. The value of this is around $18. Is it printed by the US Mint? Yes, it is. Can I deposit it into my bank account? Yes, you can. This, my friend, is money, and this is what you should be saving, not fiat currency. And you want to know how much purchasing power that this money has lost over the last 100 years? Just about none of it. I can still buy the same things that I could have 100 years ago as I can today. Now, what's the downside of holding something like that? Well, besides someone coming into your house and stealing all of it, which I guess they can do that with currency also. So the downside of holding physical gold and physical silver is that the government or governments can actually take it away from you. And if you're thinking, no, they can't do that, or you know what, I would hide it, I would bury it, blah, blah, blah. They've done it more than once, and that's in the United States of America also. So don't think that they can't enact or reenact a law taking your money from you, because they can. And here's the crazy thing, is back in the day, they would throw you in jail for 10 years and $10,000, which in today's money would probably be more like $500,000. So let's recap. I bet you the very first thing that you think of when someone says money is currency, but you can't call that money because money holds its value over a length of time. The second form of money, which actually is money, is gold and silver. And governments hate it because they can't print it, they can manipulate it, but they can't print it, and it's really difficult to control. Gold is also super difficult to mine or to get it from the ground. And from my research, now, a lot of the research says it costs around $1,200 to mine gold, but the truth is, if you really dig deep into that, it's about $800. These companies can continue to remain profitable if gold's around $800 an ounce. Which leads me into the third form of money, which is extremely difficult to teach on and explain because it's really complicated, because we have fractional reserve banking, which even saying that, people get confused. But it is basically where about 97% of wealth is, and it's actually digital. It's found on your computer screen. And now I have to explain how that works. Now, banks make their money by making debt loans. That's how banks make money. They make debt loans. So everything is loaned. Even if I were to give you, let's say I were to give you a $100 bill. I hand you the currency, the $100 bill. You take it to your bank account and you hand it to them, and they put it in your account, which shows $100. Guess what they're gonna do with that $100 bill? They're actually gonna loan it out. So that gets loaned out to someone else, and then that person walks into their bank and puts it into their bank, and their account gets shown that they have $100, and then that bank loans that $100 out, and it just keeps going and going and going. So you can actually turn, you could probably turn a $1 bill into $1,000. Okay, I am going to try to show you another way on how money's created in the banking system with the house that I'm living in. This house was purchased for $700,000. Now, let's back it up to when I purchased the house. I went into my bank and I said, hey, I would like to buy a house. And then they said, great. And they gave me a check for $700,000. I did not get $700,000 of currency. I did not get $700,000 in gold and silver and take it to someone. The bank said, you owe us $700,000. Does the bank have $700,000? No, I mean, they might have it, but they didn't have it because of me. I owe the bank $700,000, so it actually gets credited to their account as if they have $700,000 now, but they don't. You know what, over the course of 30 years, they're gonna get $700,000. They're gonna get a lot more than $700,000. They'll probably get over $1 million, but they don't have the $700,000, but they actually were able to create money completely out of thin air. And that's what the banking system does, and that's how the banks make money. There's three sources of money out there, and two of them kind of don't really exist, and they're kind of weird. You have Federal Reserve notes that you call money that actually isn't. The true name for them is called currency. And something that I didn't tell you is that there's been thousands of currencies throughout time. And guess how many of them have ever survived? Zero. Number two, there's the fractional reserve banking system. And as I showed you, it's able to create money or digits out of thin air. And number three, and last but not least, is gold and silver, which has always been around. Governments hate it. They can't print it, but the downside is if they want it from you, all they have to do is reenact a law saying you can't own it or you'll go to jail. It has been my pleasure to hang out with you today. If you have not yet subscribed, and you would just think you might want to push that button down there and subscribe, I would really appreciate it. This channel is not about me. It is about you. And thank you again. I will see you next week.